that I give warning, lest someone else be tempted to follow this most unholy path. Father, I have left instructions for this journal to be sent to you, only after I am dead. It is fitting in a way that you should be the first to hear my tale. The demon has survived. It's been many months since I took the line of terror, and he still remains before me, mocking me, and beckoning me to follow. We are fueled by the passions of our mutual hate, and he leads me daily ever onward, to the everlasting ice of the north. We are in a region uninhabited by man, and I know that he has brought me here to share his loneliness and isolation. But the emptiness and bitter cold are fitting complement to my moral resolution. For he is my creation, and while he yet remains alive, I shall remain forever. Read now, Father, of all that I have done. Do not bother to condemn me. Like the Titan who inspired omnipotence, I am already chained in eternal hell.
You gave him the wrong directions, Hans.
Yeah.
I want to tell you too, Henry. My goodness, good to see you.
his unrelenting ravings on your behalf.
Ravings indeed.
I hardly spoke of you, Elizabeth.
Now, Victor, does that mean you never spoke of Elizabeth? You should be ashamed.
Well, occasionally.
Mm-hmm.
That is to say, often enough.
Oh, give in, Victor. You only find yourself more entitled in each and every word.
Frau Mueller, may I offer you a little sherry?
Oh, yes, please.
Mind with some more brandy?
Oh, yes. Excellent dinner, by the way, Alphonse. Wasn't it, my dear?
Yes, very good. I thought the Lady Lamex especially was excellent. A little tennis could have used a bit more.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Oh, I'm sorry we had to leave early this evening, but Victor and I promised William a bedtime story.
Oh, not at all. I only wish that you would have taken me with you. But when these two begin to chatter,
they just... Now, Alphonse and I chatter? Nonsense. We were just discussing the man we hung this afternoon. Buried him right before coming to dinner.
You buried him this afternoon, Herr Mueller?
Yes. Matter of fact, I did. Immediately after we cut him down. It was a funny thing, you know. Did not work itself loose, so instead of cleanly snapping his neck like he should have, the poor beggar wound up choking to death on his own tongue.
Lionel, please! We can talk about these grisly details.
You tied the knot yourself, Herr Mueller?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I did. Then I placed it under the skull.
Lionel!
Herr Clerval, you have arrived, you know, at a most fortuitous time. Frau Mueller, Lionel, I've asked you here to be the first to know what everyone has long suspected. That Victor and Elizabeth are to finally be married.
Oh!
Well, much happiness, Elizabeth.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
I'm so glad that you have finally decided. And you must set a date if we don't wait too long. Don't give you time to change your mind.
A toast. A toast to the house of Frankenstein, the joy of its father, the loving memory of its mother, the happiness of its children, the bright promise of its future, the house of Frankenstein. What are you doing here?
Nothing, sir. Nothing.
Okay. What is that you've brought?
We have a business with Harry Victor. Is that right, sir?
Yes. I forgot.
Well, we meet again, gentlemen, eh?
You met these men before, Herr Clifford?
Yes, on the road here. They gave me directions to the chateau.
Yes, indeed we did, sir. Herr Victor, about that business.
Business? What business have you here this time of night?
Something for Herr Frankenstein, sir. Yes, sir, I'm afraid he's concerned with something very grave.
Surely I can wait until tomorrow?
No, sir, I don't think we'll keep that long.
What is that you brought?
It's certain to be induced to me, Herr Mueller. Come, gentlemen.
Victor, this is most distressing.
I'm sorry, Father. It appears to be most urgent. We'll deal with this as quickly as I can. Gentlemen?
Good evening, all. Herr Magistrate. Ladies.
Sirs, good night.
Metz and Schmidt. What did they to do with Victor?
Lord only knows. Those two have been around here before. I'm afraid that's the only sort that'll work for Victor.
Well, the villager thinks Victor's a little mad, you know?
Now, Victor.
No, do not protest, my friend. I've heard the rumors.
But, sir, what exactly is it that he's doing?
Henry, I'm afraid that we know absolutely nothing about the nature of his work.
He's told you nothing?
No. And that's why that I wrote to you. And that you would come, but he's changed, Henry. He's not the same man that he used to be yet.
When did he begin his change?
Shortly after he returned from Ingolstadt. He began by transforming the tower rooms into a laboratory where he could work without a disturbance.
And then he constructs an enormous wheel behind the tower.
A dynamo?
What?
The wheel, it's a technique for producing electricity.
Come on. Perhaps we should be gone.
Yes, perhaps we should.
Oh, no, please.
No, really, we should be getting on. We might be in for quite a storm.
I'm sorry the evening should have to end this way.
Well, as you can see, it has left us in the dark again.
I hardly find this amusing, Elizabeth. It's exactly the sort of thing that happens constantly.
No matter, Alphonse. It's always a pleasure. Elizabeth, my dear, much happiness. Herr Clerval, a pleasure.
And you, sir, and you.
Now, Elizabeth, you come see. You have much planning to do, and I'm only going to be so happy.
Come, let me see you out.
Watch out for her, my dear, or she'll take you over completely.
And good night.
satisfactory? Please, Henry, spare me your sarcasm. You're the only one who understands my fascination with the sciences.
Yes, yes, I'm well acquainted with your interests. Now, Victor, come to the point.
Henry, I have reason to believe that I am capable of reanimating life.
This is the nature of your work? This is what consumes you? This age-old pursuit of eternal life?
No, not eternal life, but rather the recreation of life.
But Victor,
hear me out. At school I came across the works of Bolos the Egyptian, the Muslim Jabir, Albert Magnus, Roger Bacon,
alchemists, magicians, good God, man!
Scientists, philosophers, perhaps magicians. Regardless, I decided to study nature, to inquire into its structure through its very secrets. I saw how the fine form of man was wasted and degraded. I watched the corruption of death succeed the book of life. I saw how the worm inherited the wonders of the eye and brain and heart. I examined and analyzed every detail of the change from life to death, until finally, I succeeded in discovering the very cause of life itself.
Really, Victor, do you expect me to believe this nonsense?
That and more. I expect you to help me in my project.
In what way?
What project? Creation of life in a man.
You believe this? You actually believe this?
I have in my laboratory the intelligent brain of one man and the healthy heart of another, kept alive by means of induction through chemicals for well beyond a week.
Good Lord!
They have only been awaiting a proper vessel in which they're to be implanted, and that was just delivered to me here tonight. The only struggle that remains is the completion of the surgery before the storm has reached its peak. And in that, you can help me.
No, Victor, I'll have no part of this.
Think, Henry, think! You have control over life and death. Perhaps erase disease forever from the human frame, to ensure eternally the existence of the greatest mind.
Do you then aspire to be a god?
God?
Yes.
I never even thought of that.
But what of the soul, Victor? The body is but the keeper of the soul, and then death releases it to heaven.
And proctors of the soul would have knowledge disregarded. Truths pronounce miracles. Mysteries were made to be solved, my friend. You taught me that. Henry, I would have to see this soul before I concluded my studies. I am no atheist, no blasphemer, merely a scientist desiring to study the purposes of life. Perhaps therefore, of God.
Prometheus?
What?
Prometheus was punished by the gods for bringing fire down to man.
Prometheus was a fool. The gods were greedy, jealous, and possessive.
You actually think you can do this?
Yes.
Victor, even if I believed in what you've said and thought that you had accomplished, I'm overwhelmed. I believe you to be a good man, a brilliant scientist, capable of anything. Yet,
God, it's fascinating. It's more than fascinating, Henry. It's true. Come, join me in this enterprise. See the wonders of which I speak. If, on further study, you decide to disagree, well, that is up to you. Meanwhile, time is precious, and there's much that must be done.
Are you certain then that I will join you?
I have no doubt at all, Henry. No doubt at all.
Come. He was bound to a rock, you know, Prometheus.
My dear friend, perhaps together we shall.
Violent chain of activity that can be animated by the proper means.
Are you familiar with Sir Humphrey Davies on the chemical effects of electricity?
Vaguely.
Have you read Erasmus Darwin's Mechanical Garden?
Well, yes, but...
Read this.
The temporary motion of a paralytic limb is likewise caused by passing the electric shock through it, which would seem to indicate some analogy between the electric fluid and the nervous fluid, which is separated from the brain by the blood, and then diffused along the nerves for the purpose of motion and sensation.
You understand?
No.
If a minor shock would produce convulsive movement, might not a greater shock produce continued animation?
Yes, yes, of course. Or carried to extremes? Reactivate a dormant heart?
Who knows?
My God!
Perhaps it is every man's God.
Yes, it may be possible. It just may be.
Here, Henry, bring down the chains.
Set out to do is far beyond us still.
We must not let simple disappointment cloud our vision now. We felt a pulse, heard the heartbeat. We gave this being life.
Victor, perhaps it is better than an end like this.
Whatever the problem, it can be amended. Just recheck, reanalyze every facet of our procedure. Every piece of equipment.
We will, Victor, we will, but first we must take some time to think about what all this means.
Yes, of course.
What are you doing?
A moment, Henry. I must determine the exact amount of power at the moment in which...
Victor! Elizabeth is right. We are both exhausted.
But Henry, I only...
Victor!
You're right. Some rest.
Perhaps you will.
This, I must attempt to amend myself to Elizabeth.
Yes, I'm afraid we owe them all some sort of explanation, especially your father.
And believe me, this storm is nothing compared to what we can see from him.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm afraid to think I've gone crazy. I'm not too sure what happens.
Well, come, my friend. Let us rejoin, at least for tonight, the current family of man.
Thank you. Which one you are?
No, it's all right.
Here, just here. Yes, warm.
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 Said, behold, the man has become as one of us, to know of good and evil, and now, lest you reach forth and take from the tree of life, and eat, and live forever.
Very good, go on.
Therefore, the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from whence? I know the word. I cannot see.
It must be getting dark. That's enough for today, then.
Adam was alone?
Yes, Adam was the first man. God created him from dust. Then God created Eve to be Adam's companion.
Companion is the same as friend?
Yes, that's right. Get some wood, then we'll begin preparing supper.
Companion. Friend.
There it is.
speak to me? De Lacy! No.
My God! I know! Frankenstein, the body's home! What are you talking about?
What have you done to him?
You were dead!
Dead?
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 Yeah. But I still remember that you gave me this.
Fritz!
Wait! Stay here. my friend.
We can be friends, but I have to find my dog first.
Fritz!
Your dog?
Yes, my dog, Fritz.
I know where he is.
Why didn't you say so?
Stay here. Here he is.
Fritz, he's dead.
Oh, no, please don't.
Don't touch me.
No, please stop.
You did this.
No.
Justine.
No, don't
help.
Scream. Please.
Heck no.
Please stop.
No.
Please.
No.
Stop screaming. Please.
No.
William, wake up. William? Fritz is dead. And William, dead. Mother, dead. DeLacy, dead. They call me dead. I am not dead. I am not dead.
My God.
No, I am not God.
You are my creator.
But I am not a God.
that.
Don't be silly. Look, not even the slightest breeze. Something wrong?
No, Elizabeth. It's just that...
Elizabeth, I found them. I've had them with me the entire time. Victor, why don't you come along with us?
Where are you going?
We're going to look for William and Justine. They...
What is it, Father? Do you see something?
Oh, yes. I caught a glimpse of Lima coming up the hill. Excuse me.
Really, if you should come with us this evening, the fresh air would do you good.
I can't just now. I'll finish up here and join you later.
Well, I do hope that you're not too angry about what you've left.
No, of course not.
All right. Well, good night.
Just say nothing until we have time to think.
Please come in, sir. I'm sorry to intrude at such a moment. I would not have come if it were not for the utmost importance.
Yes, I know.
Since your father has taken you instead, I asked Elizabeth to join us here.
Elizabeth? No, she must not know what has occurred.
She already knows what has occurred.
No, Victor! Herr Mueller, please. Victor learned of William's death only moments ago and is understandably distraught.
Yes, I understand. But you must also understand, I have a job to do. I believe we apprehended William's murderer.
What? Where did you find him?
Find who?
Who is it? Who have you arrested?
I'm sorry, I cannot say that yet.
Why are you doing this to me? Why?
Victor, occurred here, and you'll understand the strain.
Ulysses, are you all right?
Yes.
Cindery! Ulysses.
Yes?
Do you recognize this?
Yes, it was Williams. He wore it always, for it contained a picture of his mother.
Where did you get this? Where?
We found it lying next to the persons of the murderer. Its presence makes it certain she is guilty.
I don't know anything about it. I swear. I could have never hurt William. Never.
Justine?
No.
No.
Fool! Madman! It was not Justine who murdered William. It was Victor.
Not Justine.
Now, Justine, everything will be all right.
Oh, miss, please. I could not have done what he said. I love William, miss. I could have never done anything.
This is impossible. She is incapable of even harming the boy. She's like a member of the family.
I understand your concern, Herr Quirrell, but this would not be the first time a servant has turned against the family. A locket such as this would bring a fine price in certain circles.
That is impossible. Justine would never hurt William.
She would never hurt him. She's so...
Listen, can you not just wait?
I'm sorry, but I have no other choice.
Come along.
No!
Herr Mueller!
Victor, please. You must know that I'm innocent. I could have never hurt William. You cannot believe that I'm guilty. Please, Victor, say something.
Come along.
No, Victor, don't let him do this!
Elizabeth, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
How could you let that happen? Why didn't you say something? Try to stop
it. Steve is innocent. Of that I can assure you.
And it has been left up to us to prove that innocence.
We cannot, Elizabeth, we cannot.
If she isn't, then...
Victor!
Only I can end this now. Only I. I must be here.
Victor!
What do you do now?
I'm attempting to connect the muscles of the eye. This large nerve, here, carries the image from the eye to the brain. These large muscles, here, control the movement of the eye itself and the sun. The smaller ones control the focus.
Why do you do that?
The eyes must be protected from too sudden exposure to light.
Please, ask no more questions. The work is difficult enough.
I ask questions of you that I may learn.
Daily do I bring you books. I have, of necessity, taught you something of the sciences. You could assist me in this endeavor. You speak, you see, you breathe, you move, you think. You have taken the life of my brother. What more, sir, you can ask of me?
There's much more that I can ask of your creator, as any child asks of its parent.
Enough! There'll be no more talking. There is work that must be done.
But I must know more.
I said no.
Why this work?
Because you have forced me to.
No. Why me? Why did you create a being that even you turn away from in disgust? I've read your notes while here alone. I read of potions, solutions, incisions. But I found nothing that will tell me why. I'm most confused.
You are damned!
I am damned for being alive. How damned is it that brought about by me?
I want you out of my sight, out of the last clothes I love. I cannot finish here soon enough to suit me. Then I'll get rid of both you and your despicable companion.
I will hear no more, miss!
Do you threaten me again? It grows tiresome.
We have made a bargain. I will honor it.
Let's make sure that everything is ready before the storm is peaked. Throw that lever when I tell you. Now! And the next now!
She was frightened and all alone. But she managed to maintain her dignity. Hurry, stop. And she saw Elizabeth. Justine cried out. Elizabeth broke from the car and started running toward the car, but she was stopped and restrained by the gallant Mueller. She screamed Justine's name. Justine cried back over and over till the rope tightened about her neck. Silenced her forever. Where were you, Victor? What kind of man are you? I do not know you anymore.
But we agreed, Henry. We discussed it and agreed there was nothing we could do in light of her confession.
You know as well as I can she confessed out of fear for her immortal soul. Surely there is something we could have done. We... What are you doing?
I have no choice, Henry. I cannot break my promise.
Promise me? Victor, I understand. Oh, my friend, forgive me for misjudging you.
No, Henry, you do not understand.
But Victor, I do. You've lured him here and are somehow planning to destroy him. Together we've created him, and together we shall bring him to an end.
No, Henry, no!
I see no reason for you to proceed in this thing alone.
Henry, you do not know what you're doing.
Quickly, Victor, we mustn't waste any more.
You! Do you propose to stop the work that has begun? Do you dare me to break his promise?
Promise? What filthy promise have you made?
I've been alone. He is making my companion.
Companion? Victor, no, impossible! Unthinkable, I mean, creating another being such as he!
I must, Henry, I must! For only then will he depart and leave us all in peace. I have his word.
His word?
Yes.
But what of this thing you are creating? Maybe 10 times as worse as his intended mate?
I have sworn to go away.
You may have sworn, but that is not.
She will
what assurance do you have that it will comply with his wishes?
She will obey him, Henry. She must. I can see to that.
No, Victor, you must not continue in this vile, lawless act.
I am in pain and misery and loneliness. Shall each man find a wife and each beast a mate, and I be alone?
There can never be another thing like you.
I cannot reason with you, for you prove yourself unworthy. You may be my creator. But I am master here. Obey, or you shall know the power of my hate.
No, I will not waver before your threats.
Yeah. Henry! No! Yeah. Now kill me and have done!
No. So you find release in death while I remain desolate and alive?
Destroy my dreams and hopes for peace. But hear me and remember me well. I shall be with you on your wedding night!
Nearly years pass since the day you murdered Henry. This trail leads me north throughout all Europe. I shall close this journal and come home now, Father, as I lost sight of him some weeks ago, feeling must have perished from the cold. Though I will never know for certain, and the memory of his existence will continue to haunt my life forever.
Lovely, my dear. Such a beautiful bride. Well, it is Madame Frankenstein's dress, you know.
Yes, and she would have wanted you to wear it on your wedding day.
Nothing could make me happier than to be reminded of her.
If only she could be here now.
You seen Victor yet?
No, not since early this morning.
Wasn't he with Father over yet?
Lionel said he was there for a while, but then it seems he disappeared.
Disappeared?
this night had long since passed.
Victor, why do you look like that? Something is wrong.
No, it's just...
Tell me, Victor, please.
Elizabeth, there's something you must know.
What?
This is most difficult.
Tell me, please.
My experiments, Elizabeth.
Oh, Victor, please do not torment yourself like this. It has been years since I visited Henry, and you...
No, there's more. You see, I was fascinated by the powers of sleep with electricity. I began to wonder about the very origins of life.
Please, Victor, I have heard all of this before.
You have not. I discovered principles that I carried to extremes.
Extremes? Sort of
extreme. I conceived of the idea and executed the creation of a man.
A man?
Yes, a man. Hideous and deformed, perverse beyond all imagining. It was he who killed William of Clermont. He who placed the locket which condemned her next to Justine. And he who swore to be with me this very night. I know what you must think of me, Elizabeth, but I can no longer bear the guilt. I had to tell you, even though that I knew I would lose you.
No, Victor, no! Nothing you could say could make me lose the love that I feel for you.
Oh, Elizabeth.
Victor, hush now, for we are to be married soon.
Elizabeth, we must leave here tonight.
Yes, we know it's planned.
No, we mustn't even wait for that. We must leave immediately after the ceremony.
But the guests, they...
I don't care a thing about the guests. I only care that you and I are well away from here. Tell me it's all right.
Yes, of course it's all right.
Oh, Elizabeth.
Oh, Victor. Victor, I need to finish packing.
What?
Packing?
Oh, yes, of course. Tell me what you need. I'll...
Ah, there you two are. We've been looking all over for you. The guests have wondered at your absence. They... Oh, is something wrong?
No, Father. We merely thought a moment to ourselves.
We have some things to discuss. Certain memories to overcome.
Ah, yes. But let's not dwell on the melancholy past. Soon, near and dear objects of affection will be reborn, born, replace those of whom we've been so cruelly deprived.
Yes, you're right, Father. The future is the only thing that matters now.
Come along. The guests are waiting. It is time. Now come along. Plenty of time for all that later.
Victor, I've
nearly
gone without my veil.
Victor?
Yes, Father. I am here for retribution.
No, I
have been betrayed, and he shall suffer for the injury.
No, please do not harm him, I beg.
I shall not harm him in the way that you think.
Then why are you...
You shall be my instrument of revenge. Your screams shall summon him here, and he shall see that I have kept my word. I wish I did not have to harm you, but I have no other choice. So scream, Elizabeth. Scream.
No!
Scream! Please, scream! Please, I beg you, scream!
Oh my God!
Shoot him, Father! cursed thing! You have murdered the helpless and the innocent! Whatever harm you or any other living thing!
Do you think my crimes have brought me pleasure? Her death has degraded me beneath the meanest animal. Even my revenge has left me with a bitter taste.
And I? Do you think that I am free of guilt? Of pain? Of responsibility?
No. For it was you who gave me life.
Yes.
Farewell, Frankenstein. I've destroyed you and everything you ever loved. I shall die as you are dead and call me into being, and when we are gone, our memory shall quickly vanish. We shall be bound together, forever, all alone. And thus, the instruments of life become the instruments of death.
Last but not least, Miss Susan Henderson.